can only be described as our Hell's a Poppin' edition of the Morning News Continues. Here is the Tony Award winner. Melissa Jaret Winokur, nice to have you.
Hi.
Last time you were here, we had this conversation that we took Bridesmaids, which we are familiar with, and turned it into a riotous musical.
Yes.
And that was hugely successful.
Yeah, so much so it's gotten extended through November. So you can still get tickets for that.
Well, when you were here, though, you were very stressed. I remember you
had
so many. We had so much going on with your kids and the play. And
then the next play and then the Well, the Bridesmaids went great.
Okay,
the play
good.
Went great. And now I'm doing Hocus Pocus. So. Which is also a parody. I'm doing the parody of Hocus Pocus.
Okay, so we think, of course, the movie Bette Midler, amongst others.
Yes.
How does this lend itself well? And you play the Bette Midler role.
I do play the Bette Midler role. Well, it lends itself really well because I get to sing a lot of Bette Midler music.
Right.
I get to do all of the fun stuff. But look, Hocus Pocus is already sort of a parody, so we have to take it to the very next level. There I am.
Oh, my goodness.
There I am as Winifred. I mean, I love doing Hocus Pocus. Like, I just love it. I would do it every Halloween forever.
And these are our original songs, or could there be a Wind Beneath My Wings?
Oh, yeah, there are. I sing The Rose.
Oh, yeah.
No, I do some Bette Midler, amazing Bette Midler music. And Kenny Ortega came last night, who was the original director of the real film, and he loved it, so that was really exciting.
Have you talked to Bette?
I talked about last year, because I had done it last year, and I was like, I'm doing this, and she was getting ready for Hello, Dolly, and yeah. She's out of place. Everyone's excited. I mean, they're supposedly making a remake. Who knows what that is? I'm true blue. I love the original. Yeah.
What about all this? They reboot and they remake everything. Do you think that is like, a taboo thing?
You know what? I'm really torn, right? Because I like that they remake it so a younger generation can, get excited about it, because maybe the younger generation doesn't want to see the original, but then the original is so much better always.
It's
like always is better. So I don't know. I'm very torn.
Okay.
Yeah.
Could this be, I mean, obviously you've got two very successful examples here.
Yeah.
Could you be now the queen of the parody musical?
I think I'm finding definitely a niche in it, because I obviously am a comedian and a musical theater actress, and it's smarter and funnier, and it's in Los Feliz, so it's like much hipper and cooler than I am at all. You know what I mean? I just keep happening and lucking into these jobs at the Rockwell, and they're drinking and having fun. So I like a good parody. So
I do. And then, easier said than done, is there another one in the ether that you're thinking of? Oh, this would lend itself well to it?
Oh, well, Kay Pazakis, who writes all the Oompa series, we've been talking about a lot. I'm going to probably do one in the spring. And right now they're getting ready to do Home Alone. I have nothing to do with it, but they are doing Home Alone for the Christmas holiday.
Well, that
which
would be
is really fun.
A good one as well.
Yeah.
Who else is in this one with you?
Well, this one, the director, Peter Voigt, just did it. And I had actually done Happy Days with him, literally with Gary Marshall in the year 2001. I mean, like, before Hairspray, Gary Marshall put Peter and I in this, like, Happy Days the musical, back before I was even successful. So I find that really awesome.
Well, the unauthorized musical parody of Hocus Pocus is running now through November 4th. Tickets go to rockwell-la.com. Great to see you this morning. So great. I mean, with Kenny Ortega's endorsement, what else do you need?
Nothing. Honestly, nothing. Maybe if Bette showed up. That would be the only thing left. But I've sent her a lot of video clips. So,
Thank you, guys, Marissa. Great.